Argentina's vice president has survived what appears to be an attempt to kill her. It was over in just a few moments as Cristina Fernández de Kirchner was greeting supporters outside her home late Thursday. Suddenly, from among the crowd, a gun appears. The barrel pointed at her head, a click is heard, and the trigger, it seems, may have been pulled, but the weapon did not fire. The vice president was not hurt, but all of this playing out live on television. Right now, a suspect is in custody. Journalist Stefano Posbon joins us now live from the region with more. So just tell us exactly what happened here. What's the latest with the investigation?
Yes, John. Well, the latest is what we have seen from these shocking images that were streamed, broadcasted live on national TV in Argentina. You can see a man was able to get very close to Cristina Fernández de Kirchner, the vice president of Argentina, a former two-terms president of the country and arguably the most famous political figure in the nation at this moment, and draw a gun and pointing it literally at no more than 20 centimeters from her face. The president of Argentina addressed the nation shortly afterward to send a message of calm, of quietness, but also calling it the most serious attack that the nation has faced since the restoration of democracy in the 1980s. In particular, the president of Argentina, Alberto Fernández, said that the gun was armed with five bullets, and that he said, and I quote, "Cristina is alive only because for some technical reason that we have not clarified yet, the gun did not detonate," calling it then a clear assassination attempt. He also called for a day of national holiday on Friday, which is tomorrow here in South America, to rally the population around around Cristina Kirchner and calling for a moment of reflection. This is happening, John, at a moment of increased political tension in Argentina, as a prosecutor called for a 12-year sentence against Cristina Fernández de Kirchner just a few weeks ago. She's facing charges related to corruption while she was the president of Argentina a few years back. And that is why we have seen this moment where this accident, this attack, occurred during a rally of her supporters around her house, her private residence in Buenos Aires, to support and to protest against this investigation. So you can see polarization rising, the temperature of the nation is rising, and now this attack, which could act as a detonator for further political violence. Alberto Fernández doesn't want that and urged calm and used very strong words to condemn the attack. John?
So, Stefano, just to recap, we have a loaded gun, this is according to the authorities there, pointed directly at the head of the vice president. And if it hadn't jammed, then chances are she would most likely be severely wounded or dead at this point. The question about now is about security. Will security be increased? How does someone with a gun get so close to a former president and the current vice president?
Yes, definitely. And Argentina is not a nation where gun accidents are so common. It's not one of the nations in South America that has one of the most widespread gun problem, but it shows how the political tension is rising. And I think this is not just, John, an issue only for Argentina. Only a few hours ago, the brother of the Chilean president was beaten on the streets in Santiago by political opponents of his brother. And we've seen throughout the Brazilian presidential campaign, Brazil is slated for electing a new president in October, that a series of attack against left-wing activists in the last few months have left several of them killed. And so you see that across the region, there is the feeling that political tensions are growing, and that perhaps this is, yet again, another threat to democracy, at least here in South America. John.
Stefano, thank you. Stefano Posbon there in Bogota, Colombia, with the view, the big overall view of what's happening across the region. Thank you, sir.